Yes, the world is a vulnerable place. And yes, we help make it that way. Do you need us? You know why?
Do enlighten us.
Because we're also the ones best qualified to defend it.
I will bathe the Starways in your blood.
Yo, what up, everyone? Tay here. So you guys are always telling me to do more Infinity War videos, so let's do that today and just go over the slew of various Avengers 4 and Infinity War cast tidbits, news items, and some theory stuff that has been doing the rounds the last week or so. With that, I am going to be jumping around a bit from topic to topic, so yeah, let's get into it. So first, let's talk about the MCU cast members who have recently been confirmed for Avengers 4. First, let's talk about actor Hayley Atwell, who you know as Peggy Carter, and she posted this selfie on Instagram in an on-set makeup chair with motion tracking dots on her face. Now, this one isn't actually confirmed, as we don't know what the film she is on set for, but it's been speculated that she could be on set for Avengers 4, and the tracking dots are pointing to her reprising her role as the old Peggy Carter we saw Cap visit in Captain America: The Winter Soldier. However, she did later die in Captain America: Civil War, so if she does have an appearance in Avengers 4, it could be in a few different ways. It could be a flashback or a dream sequence. It could be a vision brought on by Thanos with the gauntlet in order to torment Cap, or it could even be Thanos using the gauntlet to straight up bring her back to life. But I personally find that last one the least likely scenario. But just as I was making this video, she posted in a comment on that picture on Instagram that she is saying this is not for Avengers 4, but she is not saying what movie it is for. So some people are saying, well, there you go, it's not for Avengers 4, and then other people are saying, well, she could just be saying that because Marvel got upset she posted the picture, so they're just trying to cover their tracks. So you guys be the judge. Even if it's not for Avengers 4, this picture, it doesn't mean that she couldn't still appear in Avengers 4. Anyway. Then Scarlett Johansson has also been spotted on set, which confirms Black Widow's return, and it's been reported she will be going on a mission of some sort to Japan during Avengers 4. Then Sebastian Stan has confirmed his return as Bucky to Avengers 4 in a recent interview with MTV when he spoke about not being allowed to read the full script and therefore not knowing if his character Bucky will survive till the end of the movie or not, and how it's a kind of a stressful environment not knowing where your character's going and if he's going to survive and all that. Then next, photos were also recently released of Chris Evans and Brie Larson appearing to the set together. So this confirms the appearance of Captain America's return, and more notably Captain Marvel, who Kevin Feige has said will be the most powerful hero to date in the MCU. And everyone thought we would see Captain Marvel in Infinity War until director Joe Russo said at Comic-Con that that would not actually be the case. But as suspected, it looks like she will be appearing in Avengers 4. Then Doctor Strange himself, Benedict Cumberbatch, has not been spotted yet, but his stunt double has, so that would seem to confirm Doctor Strange's role. Then Jeremy Renner ousted himself by posting a pic on set with his new haircut that he posted to Instagram, but more on that later. Then after that, we have this photo that Mark Ruffalo took on set of Paul Bettany in his full Vision makeup and wardrobe signing comics to be sent to fans. So with this one, it would seem that if Ruffalo was on set to take this picture, that would confirm Hulk. And of course this confirms Vision, who has the Mind Stone still in his head, which is notable, so perhaps he doesn't lose the Mind Stone during Infinity War like we've speculated on in past videos. Or this could also be that this is after the Avengers defeat Thanos at the end of the film and Vision gets the Mind Stone back. Because even though Avengers 4 hasn't been filming that long, they don't shoot the scenes in order. Or there could also be some other explanation that's not quite as obvious. Something else that is possible is maybe this picture is actually a few months old from the filming of Infinity War and was just recently posted to Instagram. Then moving on, this next one was pretty cool. We got to see on-set photos of Evangeline Lilly in our first glimpse of the new Wasp suit. Now, this was taken from the shoot for Ant-Man and the Wasp, not Avengers 4. However, Lily herself has confirmed in interviews that she will be in Avengers 4 alongside Paul Rudd as Ant-Man. So we will probably see a new or updated version of the Wasp suit and Ant-Man suits in Avengers 4. And I've heard differing opinions from people online about this suit, if they like it or not. I like this suit. I like the black and gray with red trim. I like the red trim as opposed to a yellow trim or yellow suit. So, but you guys let me know what you all think of this suit in the comments. Then we have also seen set photos of Tony, Pepper, and Happy doing a scene in what looks to be a park, and Pepper is sporting a fancy new engagement ring. And in a recent interview with Gwyneth Paltrow, she confirmed Don Cheadle's role in Avengers 4, so you can add War Machine to the list as well. Then after that, there's Tom Holland, Spider-Man, who hasn't been spotted on set yet, but Avengers 4 is a part of his Marvel contract. And along those same lines, the Guardians have also not been seen reporting to set either, but Zoe Saldana confirmed the Guardians' return a few months ago when she said they would be coming back for Gauntlet, aka Avengers 4, later in the year. Anyway, I'm sure most of you won't find any of that too shocking, but it does give us an idea of some of the characters who it appears will probably survive Infinity War. And it makes sense that any of the bigger heroes who might not survive the entire Infinity Saga wouldn't die until the second movie. And I'm sure over the next few months we will also hear reports and see pictures of the other actors like Chris Hemsworth being on set as well. But before I move on from this topic completely, there are two more bits to touch on. First, actor Hiroyuki Sanada, I think I'm saying that right, has been cast as a mystery role for Avengers 4, and some have been speculating that he will be playing Namor. But I personally doubt this, as the Russo brothers have said on several occasions that they won't be introducing any big new heroes in Infinity War or Avengers 4 because there's just not room for them in the story to introduce new characters and give them a backstory. Plus, I think if they were going to introduce Namor, they would get an actor who is just a little bit younger. And then next, just one more on the casting side of things, and that is a hint that Crossbones could be returning to the MCU. Now, let me explain. Actor Frank Grillo, who played Crossbones, said in a recent interview just a few days ago that there is some news about his character that nobody knows about yet that's very interesting and that he is very excited about. And I must say that is interesting, considering the last time we saw Crossbones, he was being blown up at the beginning of Captain America: Civil War. So we'll see what happens, but anyway, enough with all that. Let's move on to some other villain talk and some speculation, you know, the fun stuff. So you have seen Hawkeye's new haircut for Avengers 4 and that picture he posted, and it was a lot of people were talking about it. Well, when that pic first came out, people started talking about the possibility of this meaning Hawkeye's new hairstylings is a result of his family dying, similar to what happened in the comics. I believe it was in the Ultimates. And then a little while later, MCU Exchange put out a story that they apparently had some inside source that this is in fact true, that this does happen, you know, that his family dies in Infinity War, and then afterwards in Avengers 4, Hawkeye becomes hellbent on revenge and becomes a little bit off his rocker, drops the bow for some swords, and undergoes the new identity of Ronin. Now, I know some other channels have already talked about all that, but I'm more interested in talking about it from a little bit of a different perspective. So, in the comics, it was actually Black Widow who killed Hawkeye's family. But if that turns, you know, if this does turn out to be true about his family dying in Infinity War, it seems unlikely to be at the hands of Black Widow like in the comics, unless she was perhaps brainwashed by the likes of Thanos or Ebony Maw, similar to how Hawkeye himself was brainwashed by Loki in the first Avengers movie. But, man, if they did do that, have a brainwashed Black Widow kill his family, that would be so incredibly dark. But no matter how it could happen, it seems that if his family does die, that somehow Thanos would be tied to it or somehow responsible. And when I made my Who Will Die During Infinity video a while back, I said that they might not kill Hawkeye because he has a family, and that might be a bit too macabre for the MCU. But this other way around, with his family being the one who dies, I mean, that is just so much worse. And this is going to sound a bit sadistic, but if they did go down that road, I would actually be a bit stoked, because it means Thanos is going to be the seriously dark, savage, and vicious villain we all want him to be.
But we'll get to that first. I want to ask, how desperate of a situation is this for the Avengers? Because that is the theme of what we've seen so far.
Look, the stakes are incredibly high. I mean, our job, I wanted to turn Thanos into Darth Vader for a new generation. He's an incredibly intense character, sociopathic. He takes no prisoners, and the audience needs to be prepared when they go see these movies.
I can't wait to see Thanos. He's one of my personal favorites.
And this is one of the reasons I'm so happy it was the Russo brothers who got the job of directing the Infinity Saga, Avengers Infinity War and Avengers 4, because I think the two best films of the MCU so far are Captain America Winter Soldier and Captain America Civil War. And then close behind those would be like Avengers, Iron Man, and Guardians of the Galaxy. But I think the two Captain America movies, Winter Soldier and Civil War, those are just like the creme de la creme Marvel films, in my opinion. And both of those are serious films, and I like the comedy of the MCU as well, but I think Avengers Infinity War and Avengers 4 need to be mostly serious in tone to carry the weight of this story that's 10 years in the making. And from everything that's been said about Thanos leading up to these movies, and taking into account that the Thanos from the comics, Thanos has feelings, and he doesn't see himself as the bad guy, which to me is way scarier than some mindless Leatherface type psychopath. But in the comics, when he gets all the stones on the gauntlet, he does become corrupted by its power. And at Comic-Con, Joe Russo also talked about how for Thanos, this is a philosophical journey, and Thanos is highly, highly intelligent, so I really look forward to hearing his dialogue with the other characters and to hear his justification for his actions. You know, he's like this cosmic cult leader who thinks he knows best for all of the universe. And, you know, we saw a little bit of that dialogue in the Infinity War Comic-Con footage, and I think there will be some great back and forth between Thanos and, of course, Tony Stark, but then also the likes of Cap, Gamora, Nebula, Doctor Strange, etc. And depending on how closely Avengers 4 takes Thanos versus the Avengers battle scenes from the Infinity Gauntlet comics, could decide some of these specific cinematic scenes we might see in the movie. These could be the likes of scenes where Thanos turns Thor to glass, or when Thanos thrusts his fist into Vision's chest, or when Thanos smashes Cap's shield to pieces. And that one is a specifically, I think we will definitely see that scene for sure in one of the movies where Thanos smashes Cap's shield. And that might have been hinted at in Tony's vision during Avengers Age of Ultron towards the beginning of the movie. But anyway, I will quit rambling about Infinity War now. I am so stoked for those movies. As you can tell, every time I talk about them, I get super excited. But I do have some other Infinity stuff I was going to talk about in this one, but I'll save that for one of my next videos. And since I do have some other Infinity topics I want to discuss in those, please feel free to leave any Infinity War or Avengers 4 stuff you would like me to discuss in those vids in the comments, or any Ragnarok or Black Panther stuff for that matter as well. I do have a Black Panther vid I've been slowly working on, but I've been kind of waiting for the next trailer, because we should be getting a new Black Panther trailer any day now. So once that comes out, I will drop that. And then you can check out some of my older and more recent MCU vids linked in the description below. And besides that, please like, share, subscribe, comment, all that good shit. You know the drill. And I will be back with more MCU stuff soon. All right, thanks everyone. We'll be right back.